Now, jet pumps work fine, but I really don't like them as much as I like submersible well pumps. Before we get into why I prefer a submersible, we have to talk a little bit about what a jet pump is for those of you who don't know what we're talking about. Now, when you have a well, you're going to have two different styles of pump, either submersible, meaning in the well, or a jet pump, meaning out of the well. They function very different from one another, but we're not going to get into the nitty-gritties of exactly how they function, but more of the broad spectrum, what are they and what do they look like. The primary complaint that I get with jet pumps is the sound. These systems are much, much louder than a submersible well pump. They're so much more louder that whenever you turn on the pump, meaning it cycles on its own, and you're upstairs, a lot of times you can actually hear it from a completely different level in the house. As far as maintenance goes, you have to maintain prime in the pump. What does that mean? That means that you have to have water in the line in order for the pump to work. So if you have a line that's empty with nothing in it but air, the pump won't be able to get water out of the hole. So what this means is if you have a bad check valve, which is going to be like the little foot valve, it's like a little conical looking deal that's in the bottom of the well, if that gets stuck open, or if it doesn't close all the way or something happens to where it's not working correctly, the water line can drain and now you don't have prime, meaning you don't have water. I know there's probably going to be a few of you out there that are going to be like, oh, I can just reprime it myself. But I would say 90% of homeowners don't want to prime it, don't know how to prime it, or don't feel like dealing with that issue altogether. So then this gets us into submersibles. Submersible well pumps is basically going to look like a torpedo and it's actually in the well itself. It's going to be submerged in the water and it's going to cycle just like a jet pump is, but it will be able to get a higher pressure throughout the home. The submersible pump is going to click on when the pressure drops, and then you won't hear it at all. You might hear a rattling at the check valve in the house, but it is so much more quiet to where as soon as the thing cycles, unless you're standing right next to the pressure switch, you won't even hear the click of the switch. As far as maintenance goes, whenever you have a problem with the water, you just turn off the pump, meaning the power, and you wait a bit. So if you're running the water too aggressively, you just turn the pump off, wait a few minutes, turn it back on, and you should be back in business without having to reprime the water lines. In general, a submersible pump is far more user-friendly for almost every homeowner. So most people will transition from a jet pump to a submersible pump for ease of maintenance. To convert to a jet pump is not very cheap. I would budget between $4,000 and $6,000 if you're looking to do something like that.